If there's one thing a gamer hates, it's when their mouse skips a click. This will happen at some point in your life when the buttons of your mouse stops responding. These are just a few of the mouses that I have with broken clickers. I figured, why spend so much money on buying a new one if you can just fix them instead? That's why in this week's weekend project, I'm going to teach you how to fix and replace a broken mouse button. Not only did you save up some money, but you've also modded and upgraded your mouse with eSport grade switches. Let's start with the things that you will need. First, you'll need a soldering station, a bunch of lead, a desoldering pump or sucker, and your replacement switches. I'm using the Wano Blues. In my opinion, these are better than the Omron switches, since they kind of feel more mechanical. I have here a Razer Orochi and just some random generic mouse that I bought online for just around $2, which is kinda crazy. I just wanted to start with the cheapo mouse since this is my first time replacing a mouse button. The first task is to open the mouse without breaking it. Most of the time, screws are hidden under the gliders. You can easily peel them off with a cutter knife. Grab a screwdriver and unscrew the screws. It seems you've unscrewed them all, but the cover still wouldn't come off. Give it a slight nudge to unbuckle the hidden latches. And now it's open. It took some time to appreciate how a wireless mouse would sell for $2 while making a profit. It's pretty far from what a gaming mouse would look like from the inside. But hey, it works just fine. One peculiar thing that I found were the switches themselves. The one on the left seems slightly different from the right one. I guess they kept the cost low by placing a cheaper switch on the right side since it's the left clicker that suffers from more clicks. Let's remove the circuit board to see what we're dealing with. If there's one thing that you should know, is that the majority of mouses use the same kind of switch. They just differ in brand and in quality. To make the work easier, I'm going to use my little bench vise. We'll be using a soldering iron to melt the solder joints and a desoldering pump to suck them off. Using it is quite simple. Just charge the spring, then press the button to suck. Don't be intimidated if this is your first time using these tools. Here's a closer look. The soldering iron is used for melting the lead, while the desoldering pump creates a vacuum to suck or remove the lead. When all the joints are desoldered, the impact of the pump to the board knocks off the switch. Really handy. If you don't have a pump, you can use your good old tweezers as you simultaneously melt the joints. Some wiggling should do the trick. Let's unmount the board and get to the switches. You could actually do a switch transplant from a salvaged mouse to your broken mouse, but in my case, I just ordered some brand new switches online. You can check the links from the description below. From there, you'll find my list of good eSport grade replacement switches. Omron switches are pretty good too, but I prefer the Wano Blue switches since they give a very mechanical feel. Carefully mount your new switch to the circuit board. I decided to replace them both just to give some uniformity. Perhaps add a little tape to keep them in place as you solder them. Grab your soldering iron and solder some lead to finish the job. Once you're done, you can finally put your mouse back together. And that's how you fix a broken mouse button. If you liked the video, press the thumbs up. If you want to see more, feel free to press the subscribe button. I'll be doing another tutorial about this on a different mouse, so comment down on which brand and model you would want me to fix.